But now, going back to the question, I'd say one of them would be Robben.
Oh, yeah.
Because, mate, when he burst onto the scene, he could score whenever he wanted. He was a joke.
Just remember him with his receding hairline, nice pair of F50s on. Yeah. That smells like
it. His first few goals was like he picked the ball up in the halfway line, didn't he? And just burst through one and just scored. And he looked like he could do that whenever he wanted.
Yeah, it kind of moved it like a little bit Sterling-esque, you know, it's not obviously not the wrists, yeah, but like that just quick change of direction, that little like almost untidy shuffle. But yeah, it was until, I think it wasn't it Pulisic and then Tammy Abraham, but until this season, I think he was still Chelsea's youngest hat-trick goalscorer.
Who was he?
I am Robert.
Oh, was he?
And you forget like just how young he was as well when he was at Chelsea. That's a great shot. Lucas Leiva, I am Robin. All the purest choice here, Glenn. Class. Is there anyone else you want to give a special mention to?
Did you think when Drogba came in, because obviously he came from the French league, sometimes we've seen players come over here and not adapt, and obviously, did you think Drogba would have the illustrious career he did?
No.
Was it evident from day one?
No, probably wouldn't have thought he'd be as good as he was.
No.
But that's not... Yeah. That's saying because how good he was, you know. So, but if you've got a perfect physique for the Premier League, then it's Drogba.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So he was always going to find his feet eventually. Yeah. And then, as you saw, start throwing defenders. Mm.
Philippe Senderos, yeah, absolutely ruined it. Never ever the same player after that against Drogba.
It's like Vidic and Torres.
Yeah.
What about, like, conversely, then on the flip side, players that join with massive reputations,
the worst
like Shevchenko. The question's setting Glenn up here. No, but players like Crespo and Shevchenko that came as like world class players and just didn't have, and Varane as well, and just didn't have that same effect.
Yeah, it's odd. Well, even Torres. Yeah. I was with Torres at Liverpool and he was ridiculous, but then he went to Chelsea, similar like to the lads you just mentioned, for whatever reason, it didn't tick. But Pacheva was the mad one because the year before that, we played Milan in the pre-season, and the game was a decent game. But he came on, scored two, and won the game on his own. He was incredible. And obviously, as a young kid, you know, we used to watch Eva growing up, and then think now he's come to Chelsea, can't wait to see him training, and like literally in awe of him. And literally, you couldn't believe it's the same fella.
It was mad.
But I don't know if it's confidence or what. But
what, was he not even that good in training either?
No.
But it's just
not for the level we're used to.
Yeah.
You sort of a few players like that. It's just, you know, like you mentioned Torres, like Kaká, who like injury. They still got big money moves after their injuries have kind of robbed them of the player they once were. And that was mad. Varane as well. Like what a footballer.
He was unbelievable. Like. He in training, he was unbelievable, like ridiculous. You could watch him all day.
Yeah,
watch him all day.
Who did we have? I think it was Andy Cole that said. Varane was just an unbelievable professional.
Yeah,
like what is that the impression you got at Chelsea as well?
Well, I don't know about the professional bit, but
might be good.
But in terms of the performances, then he was. It's just literally beautiful to watch. You know, every touch was immaculate. And like I say, what was I, 18 at the time or 19?
Because he was like a Claudio signing, wasn't he? And then obviously when Jose came in, he wanted players that would play for him, wouldn't it? Kind of thing. Like, so he kind of moved them on. We went on loan, didn't he? And then
that's right. Yeah.
Were you ever carted off at half time?
No, not at half time. No.
Because that must be, you know, when the substitution's made at half time. If it comes off, the manager, you know, he's given all the credit in the world, but as the player who's bought off at half time, you must be absolutely reeling.
Oh, you'd be fuming, you would be fuming. The but funny enough, I was playing with Bridgie and what was it, Bridgie? I've been Bridgie and Wright Phillips where Mourinho took him off after 30 minutes.
Yeah. What game was that in?
Fulham?
Against Fulham. Was that a matter of, did the team just have to be like, listen, lads?
No, I think it was more to send a message, to be honest.
Okay.
They wasn't that bad.
What, they were like the cannon fodder?
Yeah.
But that was the thing at that time, wasn't it? Everything Jose did just seemed to be the right thing.
Yeah.
Just everything.
Yeah, the meat that's touched,
didn't
it?
Yeah. But who did you play with? I don't want to, you know, you have to name any names. You're not comfortable with it, Glenn, but who reacted the worst to being substituted off that you played with in your long, illustrious career, Glenn? He's got a name.
Yeah, you know what? Yeah, but not because it's a bad thing. It was actually that Matai Kezman.
Okay.
But not bad sub in general. It's just this one incident. And I was sad because he spoke about it in the press anyway. But yeah, I think it was a Champions League game and he hadn't been getting much time to play. And I think he started the game and then got took off too early, shall we say. And we walked into a smashed up dressing room.
I love that.
It's fucking brilliant.
Dave, I love it. And that's the sort of thing where Dave would be like, there's not enough of that in football anymore. I want one of those Arsenal players to do it.